I will start anyway. It's not about us, I think. For some years, like something like 20 years now, I've been doing stuff with Perl. Started in 1994, and most of the time I've been doing the marketing. Liz is the technical genius. I'm doing the marketing, getting clients and stuff. I've been making marketing stuff about Perl for 15 years, and people keep on asking me questions about why do you do that and how and stuff. Well, why I do it is very easy. Because Perl is awesome. Yeah, awesome means. If you have any questions, please fire away. Well, this is one of the reasons that I do marketing for Perl, because many people say that we suck at marketing, and I just know that when we as a Perl community do something about marketing, we do it on an excellent way. When we do it in a good way. People notice, people see it, but most of us don't do it. So this talk is about you getting to do some marketing for Perl, in French, in English, whatever, but just do it. So mostly it's true, it's not very visible, it's not hip, it's not flashy. Well, why I do it? The last couple of years I do it because I have a lot to thank Perl for. I earned my money with Perl. We have been making websites since 1994 as the first company in the Netherlands, and we made nice money for that. I've been making scripts as well, even some heavier programming sometimes, but I've never been a very good programmer. That's always been Liz and the people that we hired to work in our company. So that's what I've been doing since then, since I've not been programming. Manager, human resources, project management, account management, oh man. And of course all those other bureaucracy stuff that Liz doesn't want to do, so I had to do them. Anyway, we earned a lot of money thanks to Perl, and we wanted to do something back. Well, again, this is one of the reasons why Perl is awesome. A lot of awesome things that are related to Perl. And as you can see, there is a lot of companies working with Perl. Yes? Ernst, hè? Send me a link. You've got my email address. Okay. I will talk about that later. Yeah. So I do my bit, but I don't blog. Well, I don't do it often. I don't code. My last line of code is 9 years ago. I don't have any Perl projects that are mine. I don't have any modules on CPAN. I do some marketing, and most of my marketing is by being there. I just go somewhere and I say, hi, we all love Perl, don't we? And then we talk about Perl. And sometimes I have books or whatever with me. One of the examples, I always go there, Amsterdam XPM. We have two Perl Monger groups in Amsterdam. We have the Amsterdam Perl Mongers and the Amsterdam expat Perl Mongers. The expats wanted to have their own Perl Monger meetings because then they could speak English. Because the Amsterdam Perl Mongers, we don't speak English. No. Can you understand me? I'm talking gibberish. So we noticed that by being there year after year, we have a positive effect. One of the things we go to is FOSDEM. It's the biggest open source event in the world. 6,000 to 7,000 people coming there. And the first couple of years we had the remark like Perl, but Perl is dead, isn't it? And they don't say that anymore because they know we are not dead. We are very much alive. That's why I made those buttons as well. So when we all do that, just come back, they will know, other people will know, Perl is still there, and they might go back to Perl from where they have gone, like that snake thing. So we will have a positive effect, and it also means that we are visible, we are accessible, and we get attention and we give attention. So this is a shot at FOSDEM. We had two tables, Perl and Perl. We had the camels and the tuits and all the other things. And over there you will see the table with Python, and there's nothing on it. Almost nothing. And they were angry that we had two tables and they only had one table. What I would like everybody to do is do more than just be there. You have to do some of these, maybe all of them, but do that. Talk, listen, write, read, present, watch, ask, answer, etc., etc. When you do that, you will help Pearl, and at the end you will help yourself. I will come back to that again, but helping Pearl means helping yourself when you like Pearl. Only when you like Pearl. If you don't like Pearl, then do what you want. Can't imagine people not liking Pearl, but still. Okay, online or offline, when you notice that somebody is asking a Pearl question and nobody answers, if you answer it, you have helped Pearl. You have helped that person, you have helped yourself in the end. If somebody says, but Pearl is dead, you reply, no, Pearl is very much alive, thank you very much. And you can be wittier than me, funnier, I'm quite sure. If you see an announcement for a Pearl event, you share it with other people. You post it on the Pearl mailing list that you are a member of. You mention it in your blog. You will get your presentation about Pearl on the schedule, like I did there, for the Polish Pearl workshop, and today again for the French Pearl workshop. And Laurent was silly enough to add my presentation to the schedule. Thank you. you will try to convince your colleagues to come as well and maybe to have a presentation as well. If you see something strange or negative, you will correct that. You will write an answer or whatever, or chat. Like, why are you so negative? It can be much better than that. You can go to meetings, Pearlmongers, workshops, YAPSI, Hackathon, FOSDEM, OSCON. Well, OSCON is a bit far away, but it's a very nice one. You wear a Pearl t-shirt, Pearl buttons, Pearl stickers. You carry around your... Hang on. This thing works. Okay. You carry around two bits with you. Anyway, that is what I do. My style of marketing for Pearl is guerrilla marketing. Look it up. Guerrilla marketing is very useful if you don't want to spend a lot of money on what you're doing. It's also very effective. And I've noticed that for having my own company for 25 years, and that type of marketing gave me many, many clients and big ones. That's not my style. My style is not advertisements, billboards, the things that cost you tens of thousands of euros. Because people see that once, they turn their head like, ugh, I don't want to see that. And they walk away, you've lost your money. I do a little bit of sponsoring, like I bought lunch today. No, I bought lunch, that's it. And if I go to a conference, there's always the possibility to pay a bit more than is the minimal amount required. I've got the money, so I can do that. If you have, you can do that as well. Anyway, going to events shows other people that they're not alone. Like one big happy family. Nice people. Look at them, they're happy. Okay. I said it already. Convince other people to go. So, I think it's a bit circular. If you make Pearl more visible, and if you help more versions of Pearl to be developed, companies will continue to use Pearl, maybe other companies will start using Pearl, and more people will use Pearl, and when more people use Pearl, Pearl is more visible, and new versions of Pearl will be developed, and hang on, I'm there already. Yeah, that's circular. About sponsoring again, it makes it affordable for other people to come, because not everybody has money. Some of you are here without sponsoring. What I do more, I love books, so I buy books. I buy Pearl books, a lot of Pearl books. Well, you have seen the things. Yeah. At the moment, it's something like 450 Pearl books. Yes? 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 Yeah, I got it. Yes, the last owner came to me at Vosdam and said, "Oh, Wendy, you deserve it more than I do. When you have it, you will bring it around the world." So, okay, cool. Thank you very much. It's a very lovely action figure. Yes. Oh, there. It's this big and it can move its arms.
On a envoyé des photos de Larry Wall, ce mec-là. Il a regardé, il a dit, il faut absolument que je fasse une poupée de lui. Il est trop marrant, ce mec, avec son petit truc et ses chemises, avec les fleurs. Et on a beaucoup rigolé. C'était pour le vente aux enchères, pour le YAPC. Et on l'a vendu, mais au moment où on l'a dévoyé pour Larry, il était un peu... OK.
So I also have some French books. You see Total Perle there and Perle Moderne. So I think I've got 95% of all books that have been, all Perle books that have been published in English. I certainly have all Dutch language books and quite a lot of German ones. So I do collect them. And today I got a very nice edition from the French Linux magazine about Perle. Thank you. Yes, thank you very much. And by the way, I think there should be more books about Perl 6. Yeah, Perl 6. I want that. At some point, people asked me about those books. Hey, Wendy, are those books for sale? Well, no. This is my collection. I'm not going to sell you my collection because then I have to start collecting them again. And some of those books are very difficult to get. But actually, that's a good idea. Sell Perl books and maybe at a low price. Let's see. So I asked O'Reilly, my first publisher of choice at that time, still mostly is, can I sell your books? Yeah, of course. We'll give you a big reduction in your price. That's fine. Really? Yeah? Okay. So now I can sell Perl books for a small price to Perl people, and Perl people are happy with that, and they continue using Perl. Yay! That's marketing. So now we are a bit later, and I'm selling books from 5 publishers. And today I sold 13 books already, so thank you very much, all of you. So, books, selling books. You've seen that. This is from Vosdam again. Tuwits. Gábor Szabó helped me to get Tuwits. He found out of a company, the Old Time Wooden Nickel Company in San Antonio. I've been there. Last year at Yapsi, North America, it was in Austin, which was 80 miles away from San Antonio. So off we go in the car, visit the Old Time Wooden Nickel Company. And they have a lot of wooden nickels. And I ordered wooden nickels with them, Tuwits. I ordered a lot of Tuwits with them. So this is the Tuwits that I had made so far. From a year, Perl 5 and Perl 6 working together, community, etc., etc., and the last one was the full color Camellia. I did order 11 types more already, and they have them finished now, but they forgot to send them to me. Otherwise, I would have them here. So, come to the Yapsi North America and collect them there, and just meet me in Orlando, okay? I will give them to you. I have to adapt this. I have these made now. So I've got Denser, Modulicious, Catalyst, P2, and 2014 Tuwits made now. And they're full color with logos. So next time I can show them to you. And P2, for the people who don't know what it is, P2 is the project by Reinie Urban in America. And he wants to connect Perl 5 and Perl 6. So Perl 5 plus Perl 6 is Perl 11. Perl 11, 1 plus 1 is 2, P2. It's the logic of Reinie Urban. He's amazing. So, yes. Just before I traveled here, I got around to it. Did not receive them, sorry. Buttons. I have a friend who makes buttons for me. Buttons, when you wear them, they show your commitment. I've got lots and lots of buttons. Very proud of them. Today I gave one away at the baker who made our baguettes. She said, "Hey, I remember you. I remember your button." So I gave her my button and she put it on immediately. So she's doing marketing for Pearl now. She doesn't understand a thing about programming, but she likes it. Stickers. I've seen people give away stickers and I thought, I should do that. But then try to find a company that makes stickers. Well, I found one. It's called Dr. Sticker in the Netherlands. Of course, Dr. Sticker. Now I have stickers. Stickers everywhere. Stickers. Lots of stickers. I will make more as well. A friend of us told us about the lovely camels. Lovely, lovely, lovely camels. And he told me that they are made in Dubai. He gave me a link. And now I've got camels. I've got a lot of camels. I have an immense amount of camels. And you can use them for a lot of things. Sorry, I know this should be butterflies, but they don't have toy butterflies like this yet. Well, maybe they have, but I haven't found them yet. Company No Starch from the books. Pearl one-liners and wicked cool Pearl scripts. They make mugs of Pearl. I've ordered them, but they're still not here. I'm sorry. I sold them all in Poland and the Czech Republic and the Netherlands. So, but I have lots of them. Liz did not want to carry our collection of books because they are a little bit heavy and our car is not big enough to carry them all. Two books have been stolen by me. Yes, from me. Yes, from me. Not by me, but from me. Hmm. So now we made those roll-up banners and they are a bit lighter, easier to carry around. Still, if you go by plane, they're just a little bit too big to put in your suitcase. So that's a bit of a problem. I made brochures. That's the three I made. You will recognize the Pearl event calendar. I like that most because it's also my agenda. Did you have a question? Okay. I plan to make more brochures. That one is getting important because I have one and I'm running out of it and I don't have the source for it, so I have to type it all over again and really make it nice. And I'm not a good designer, so it's a lot of work. And I plan to make t-shirts, plan to make a mug of Pearl 6, and I plan to make WeCircuit marketing cards, but maybe an adaptation for that, because WeCircuit marketing is negative and marketing should be positive. So I have to find out how to make that slogan a bit more positive. Thank you. Yes, that's a very positive thought. Yes, yes. I could have thought of that. So I ask, when I go to an event, when I go somewhere and I see other people have t-shirts, buttons, stickers, etc. that are related to Pearl, I walk over to them and ask, are you going to take that home with you? Yeah. Do you want to take them home with you? No. Well, at the end of the conference, you can give them to me. I will take them home and I will give them away to other people at other events. So some of the things on the table at the other room are from people that gave them to me. So I can give them around and make them useful. Because if they throw them away, it's not useful, is it? So if you have something that you can give away, I'm here. That's what I said. I will do that. When I am somewhere, like at the French Pearl Workshop, I ask for a table. And of course, Laurent, he's so frightened of me, he gives me a table. And I put books and stuff on there. And I will cover the table with Pearl stuff. So please join me, ask me for my buttons and tools, etc. Take them home, take them to your company and give them to your colleagues and friends and family and stuff. Let them get used to Pearl stuff. This is what people asked me. Wendy, have you some stuff for me? So I made two packages. Hang on. This one was for the Russian Pearl Workshop that is going on right now. At the same moment that we are doing this, they are in St. Petersburg with that package. And that package is now in Thailand, in Bangkok, for the very first Southeast Asian Pearlmonger meeting. Yay! So, what can you do for Pearl? Well, of course you do what most people do. Hack, upload, program, and hack some more. But this is what I really want you to do. Publish. This type of publishing. When you are working on a project, at some point make a press release about what you're doing. Make an announcement on your on the website of your company or your own website, on your personal blog, on Facebook, Twitter, Usenet, on chat about it on IRC. Talk about your stuff. Most Pearl people don't publish because they consider their work just like work. Boring work, let's go to work, nothing special, and other people should publish and not you, because my writing is bad, my English is bad, my work is not interesting, blah, 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 blah. Lame excuses. Come on, publish! You should publish about your blog. Like, I've wrote this amazing article about thingy. This year, I found about that one. I knew about this one and this one. That is Booking, and that is the Dutch Traffic Information Service. They use Pearl. Pearl used on highways. They use Pearl to collect information about traffic jams and stuff. But I like this one the most. The supermarket that Liz and I go to do our shopping, all their cash registers are Linux computers with Pearl on it. And it's a team of four people who do that, who program that. And they don't want to go to workshops or hackathons or conferences. They don't want to write about it. They don't want me to come over and interview them. And please don't tell the name of the company. It's Albert Heijn, but it's a very nice supermarket. But that's amazing. It's thousands of shops in the Netherlands, and they're big. So please publish. Like these people, they publish. And some of them have very, very nice blogs. Maybe I should put the blog of Liz there as well. I know now that you have one. I can find it. So I will add your name at some point. Read our blogs and see why it's all awesome. Gets the job done. It's used in lots of fields. If your company is using Pearl and has a job opening, please use jobs.pearl.org to announce that, because you never know how easy it is to get a new Pearl programmer in the company because of this. There's an amazing list of companies. It's compiled from the listing on jobs.pearl.org. And it's made by Vicky Brasseur, and the list contains some very impressive names, and it's a big list. It's a really, really big list. This is just four pages of it. Eight pages. Oh, many more pages. This is just something like 10% of the whole list. It's an immense list of names, and done by Vicky Brasseur. Wonderful job. It's very good marketing for Pearl. So you can help. Add companies to that list. So if you know a company that is not on the list, send me an email and I will make sure that will be on the list. I want to know the name of the company, the type of business, where the headquarters is, how many people are working there, and how many people are working on Pearl. And the numbers don't have to be exact. If you don't know the exact number, just tell me. They have a team of 5 developers. Might be 3, it might be 7. Yes? If they are programming in Pearl, even in small scripts, when they use Pearl for some important business in the company, they use Pearl. Yes? No, If your company is working with Python and using regular expressions, they're using the Python version of the regular expressions, not the Perl version. I think so. So that's not working with Perl. No, that's working with Python. And don't tell me. Well, maybe you tell me. Together we might turn them around to see the right side of the force. So blah de blah. You can help by marketing a lot of stuff. You can give me that, or you can make that for your own company. It's very welcome. And let your company be a sponsor as well. That's good for Perl. It's good for your company. It's good for. It goes all the way back. If you do something that's good for Perl, it will be good for you at the end, because you will keep your job. Do you want to move over to Java or whatever? No? Okay, good. Sponsor Perl. I'm almost done, by the way. CPAN is awesome. This is the growth in the number of releases every year. And this is just the first 2 months of 2014, and it's going to be somewhere there as well. This is the number of of modules per author, and there's 0.2% of the authors have more than 1,000 releases on CPAN. So, how many do you have? Freaks, yes. So you can help CPAN a lot of different ways and do that, and of course at the end publish about it, like we made a new version of DBX class and now we can have object-oriented stuff or threading or something. Please make us see more ways in which Perl is awesome. Wear t-shirts, publish, visit events, hack code document, do all that stuff. It means love for Perl, and I really would like you to spread the love of Perl. And by the way, thank you all for helping Liz and me get the White Camel Award last year. So.